Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the house of God. Boy, it's great to be here. You guys are precious people, not in my sight, but his sight. You loved him enough to come in. You loved him enough to worship him. You loved him enough to praise his holy name of Jesus. Oh, thank you. I pray tonight in the Holy Ghost, Father, that you'll just feed us as these precious Pam and Jerry come to sing, that their precious anointed voices will encourage people in these pews, in and out of these pews, and your Holy Spirit will just flow through them, Father, as you use them as their servants of God, Father. I just pray it'll be a wonderful time and a wonderful fellowship with you, Father. I just pray these things will go. And I pray, Father, for this nation tonight. I pray, Father, for the pastors all over the world, Father. The Holy Ghost is just coming on me right now. I never prophesied before in my life as a pastor, but I feel the Holy Ghost moving on me right now. I pray about these end times, Father, that these backsliding pastors, Father, that are not honoring the Sabbath, they're shutting down the Sunday night services, they're shutting down the Wednesday night services. Oh, Father, great Heavenly Father, that get them into their heart that they're shutting Jesus down when they don't let him operate in his church, when they're closing the precious church of God Almighty down. They don't allow the fivefold ministry to preach anymore. The preachers, the pastors, the evangelists, the preachers, and the teachers. They're shutting the Holy Spirit that you had gifted them to preach and minister to the flocks, Father, that they have backslidden in their heart against you. They become slothful and sluggard and lazy, so-called men of God, to shut the house of God down. They're too lazy to preach the gospel anymore. Oh, Father, I pray that you'll reunite their souls into repentance. Put fire back into their hearts to preach the word of God. They can't even keep the house of God open for 2 days out of the week. Shame on them, Father. I pray that you'll call them into repentance, Father, to rejuvenate their spirit, to put them on fire again to preach the gospel, to open up the church Sunday night, to open up the church Wednesday night, Father, to minister to the flock, Father. And you said in your precious word in Ezekiel 34 that when flock scatters, when there's no shepherd, oh, I pray, Father, that you'll put it on their hearts that they shut down the house of God, that souls could have been coming down that aisle to get saved, that people are going to hell because of them, because they haven't done your will. You anointed them to preach the word, and they become slothful and sluggard in the servanthood of you, Father. Rejuvenate that. Repent that, Father. Put it back into their hearts to get back in and preach the gospel again on Wednesday night, to never shut the house of God down. If one ministry folds, another one will take up. That the church was never meant to ever be shut down. If the preacher can't preach, then the teacher will come up. There's fivefold people in that ministry that you pressured and anointed, Father. Spiritual gifts that you've given them. And when the house is shut down, Jesus is shut down. Oh, I pray you, Father, you'll open the church back up. Open their minds of these backsliding pastors, Father, to put them in their hearts to preach again. Or, precious Heavenly Father, retire them if they don't want to do it. If they don't want to repent and open the house, God, back up, get rid of them, Heavenly Father. Put some young pastors in that are not afraid to preach the word and not afraid to sing and to teach and the fivefold ministry, that they don't get weary and well-doing. I bind that spirit, Heavenly Father, of getting weary and well-doing and serving God. Loosen and regenerate them with your Holy Ghost. Give them a fire back to get that word preached. Oh, Heavenly Father, we ask these things in the precious name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen. And,
before we start, I'm going to sing a song. I don't know, the Holy Ghost got on me. It's the craziest thing to happen to me. And I can't sleep. I get up. I got into that word last night. This hadn't happened in a long time. I started reading that word for 2 hours. And a precious young lady in Ollie's store heard me talking to another person about the Lord. And she just approached me. And she had so much on her mind about asking me why all these bad things are happening. I'm not going to get into details. I'm going to cut this real short. But I answered all of her questions and comforted her. And that was like a flow that I couldn't experience. It's just a wonderful joy to be used to give him the glory. But I helped that young lady, and she's diagnosed with leukemia now amongst all of her problems. But I had a chance to minister to her. But the Holy Ghost put this song that I'm going to sing. It's about the end times, about the church and all. And I'll sing this, and we'll get started, okay? So I'm under 15 minutes, amen? I'll sing this a cappella. The song is called The Great Falling Away. I remember long ago when the Spirit would fall. Now people weren't ashamed to praise the Lord. Now they say we're old-fashioned. The backsliding church has lost its passion. They're shutting down Sunday and Wednesday night services, becoming the great falling away. Did amazing grace somehow fly away? Did someone stop preaching about redemption day? Church buildings and altars are empty. Hearts are so cold. I guess this must be the great falling away. Oh, the perilous times Paul wrote about are here. Wickedness and ungodliness abounds everywhere. Men's hearts search for answers in a sea of question. Lord, help them to see the great falling away. Did amazing grace somehow fly away? Did someone stop preaching about redemption day? Church buildings and altars are empty. Hearts are so cold. I guess this must be the great falling away. Church buildings and altars are empty all over this world. I praise God, this must be the great falling away. Falling away. Amen.
Yeah. I was waiting on Pastor Greer to preach.
Yeah. We're cutting it out to get people out of here earlier. We're cutting the preaching out.
I appreciate Jerry and Pam Maples coming tonight and singing at the church. And they're going to bring us a good, probably 40, 45 minute message or song ministry. And I think Rocky Rue, Baptist band is going to give us a few songs, right? They won't next sing it now.
Sing along with this one right here. That was good singing there. You need to let us back you up next time on this.
Yeah. That's a simple chord, easy to probably pick up on.
Yeah. All right, you'll have to sing this good old Easter Brother classic. While the world looks so funny as I struggle along, they say I have nothing. Thank you. 'cause there's a room.
Come on, Wayne.
Up above me, that's a good place. Sing it. We're going to sing this one out.
There's food on my table.
And what?
And shoes on my feet.
One more time.
You gave me your love, Lord.
And
the
they're not you, and I don't have much money, but Lord, I have you, and that's all that matters, though the world may not see. Thank you, Lord, for your blessing. Everybody sing the chorus with us. There's a roof
up above me,
now a good place
to see. There's food on my table, and shoes on my feet.
You gave me your love, Lord. Song back here, the drummer called "I'll Fly Away." Y'all just stay in here. Don't fly out. Just stay right in here.
We might fly at the rapture takes place. No, I'm just kidding. Go ahead.
There's a little room we got in here. Is anybody here tonight for the first time? Raise your hand. Well, y'all know the room then. It don't cost you nothing to get in. It just costs you $25 to get out.
I'll fly away.
Cheap.
I'll fly away, oh glory.
Yeah, go ahead. Just how you want to do it?
We do it now, and then we'll let them close it out.
Good enough. Oh, no, hey, well, no, let's close it out then. Let you close it out.
Yeah, we'll close
it out. We'll do at least one song before we close.
Yeah, well, let's let them make
it. Yeah, let's let them make it.
Y'all take a break, huh? Come on.
It's all good.
They hear me all the time. I want to hear some talent.
Hey, what's the name of your group?
Well, it goes that far as to say that.
Let's all put your hands together and make welcome the Maples. Come on.
Singing for him, Jimmy.
Oh,
sing,
is that the name of it?
Yeah, singing for him. All right. Singing for him. Hallelujah.
Works,
amen.
Usually works better when you turn them on. We are the Maples from Rover Simpsonville area, and we attend Abitrose Cowboy Church here in Pelsby. We just love to go sing for the Lord. We're not professionals by any means. Just love to lift up the name of Jesus, and we'll go wherever God opens the doors for us to go. And this first song we will sing, this past weekend we celebrated the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ. So this is kind of our song for that. And if you know them, sing along with us.
Jesus is alive and well. Jesus is alive and well. Tell everyone you see, tell them for me that my Jesus is alive and well. He's sitting with the Heavenly Father, interceding for you and me. Tell everyone you see, tell them for me that my Jesus is alive and well.
They better get their house in order. He's gonna split the eastern sky. Get the message out to the people.
Yes.
And let's tell when there's time to tell that the Son of God is risen. Hallelujah. And my Jesus is alive and well.
Amen.
Jesus is alive and well. Jesus is alive and well. Tell everyone you see, tell them for me that my Jesus is alive and well. He's sitting with the Heavenly Father, interceding for you and me. Tell everyone you see, tell them for me that my Jesus is alive and well. When they nailed my Jesus to that old cross, the devil danced around the tree. He thought he had the children of God, and he would take them and throw them in a fiery sea. But on the third day, the stone was rolled away. The angel said, Mary, go and tell that the Son of God is risen. Hallelujah, my Jesus is alive and well. Jesus is alive and well. Jesus is alive and well. Tell everyone you see, tell for me that my Jesus is alive. Jesus is alive and well. Jesus is alive and well.
Amen. I tell folks when we go out and sing, I always got the words here in front of me because this 78-year-old gray matter goes on vacation every once in a while. So.
And when his goes, mine go too.
I hear you, brother. I call it a senior citizen moment. When I mess up, I say I had a senior citizen moment. I got to blame it on
something. I had a senior citizen seizure or something.
You know, when you're 50, when you're over 50, your back will go out more than you will.
This song, I know it's an oldie. My granddad used to sing it to me a lot of years ago, and it's one I've loved for a long time, and I'd just like to sing it for you tonight.
Of course, to redeem us senior citizens, you got to say the older the violin, the sweeter the music. Amen.
Many years ago, in days of childhood, I used to play till evening shadows come. Then winding down that old familiar pathway, I heard my mother call and said, "Oh, son, come home, it's supper time. The shadows lengthen fast. Come home, it's supper time. Supper time. When mother used to call from the back porch of the old home place, "Come on home, son, it's supper time." But time has woven a realization of a truth for me that is even more thrilling, and that is when the Lord Himself calls from the portals of glory, "Come on home, son, it's supper time." When all of God's children shall be gathered around the throne of grace for the greatest supper time of them all. Come home, it's supper time. The shadows lengthen fast. Come home, it's supper time. And we're
then you had some good home-cooked meals. Today, there ain't no supper time. They go to fast food, you know? Ain't that a truth, amen? You'd be lucky to get a home-cooked meal anywhere nowadays with fresh vegetables. You know what I'm talking about. Go ahead, didn't mean to interrupt.
When I see the sun rise in the morning, when I feel the wind blow across my face.
That's all right. Bless them, Lord. Satan, you ain't gonna steal away our joy. Get out of here, Satan, you know. We just warming up, amen. We just starting, amen. Hallelujah.
Had a short entrance to it.
When I see the sun rise in the morning, when I feel the wind blow across my it's all part of God's amazing grace.
Yes. Amen. Hallelujah.
And I believe there's a place called heaven.
That song was beautiful. I'm telling you, the words of that song, oh, it just went into my soul, you know. Satan and devil, you know, he tried to attack them in the beginning, but this couple, a true army and soldier of God, didn't allow it to steal their joy. When things go wrong, Jesus makes it right.
Amen.
And that song come through. They didn't quit on God. They pressed on. And it ministered, amen. Hallelujah. Thank God for y'all.
Thank you,
Jeff. I love it. Amen.
This is an old song, too. But in fact, it's a song we just learned to sing not too awful long ago. But we knew it from many, many years ago.
Well, I've been singing it with my grandfather since I was a kid.
Hey.
That was a long time ago.
That was a short time ago. You're young. Go ahead. Just...
I'll be 68 my birthday.
When trouble surrounds us, when evils come, the body grows weak, the spirit grows numb. If these things beset us, he doesn't forget. That day he was baptized.
Just comforted my heart so much at that time. Well, not to realize that February, the end of February that same year, she started attending Happy Trails Cowboy Church. And sometime along in June, I set the music up on Sunday nights and Tuesday nights for the church. So along in June, one of the ladies in the church told me, she said, "I got a lady back here who wants to sing." Okay, so I go back, get her phone number, and set her up to sing in August. Well, when she came off the platform that night, I said, "Pam, you and I need to sing some duets together." I said, "Because the Lord's put you here to sing."
Yeah.
And at that time, she had just about given up singing. But to make a quick story out of this thing, we started singing together in November. October, we started actually dating in October. December, I asked her to marry me, and she said yes. And
in front of the church?
Yeah. In front of the church, one of the guys said, "You wasn't afraid she was going to say no?" I said, "No, nah, she's been planning a wedding for a month. I know
we've been planning a wedding."
But anyway, God put us together to do His ministry. We just loved going on and singing and having a good time. You ready, Laura?
I wasn't looking because I'd been a widow for 17 and a half years, so I was not looking.
Well, that ain't odd. That's God. Amen.
That's right.
Amen.
Ready? Some things I may not know. There are some places I can't go, but I am sure I'll miss one thing. My God is real, for I can feel Him in my soul.
Church asked us to learn this song.
He's 84.
Loved it when he was growing up, and he said,
I want y'all to learn this for us. So we found the words and then the music to it, and we learned it. So we're going to give it a try.
Well, the thing about Atlee, he's 84, I think, or 86,
he's
somewhere. He's old. But he's told all of us, he said, when I'm 100, I'm taking out 100 pretty girls for dinner at one time. He said, and you're going with me. I said, you got it.
With George Burns, and he still had a cigar in his mouth. George Burns, I think, lived to be 100.
Yeah. I can't take him anywhere.
You can trust me, but you can't take me out, do you?
Look, he told him to the
put all this stuff on a cassette or on a computer so we can just play it. But
modern technology.
Oh, my doubts, and it calms my fears, and it dries all my tears. Oh, the blood that gives me strength.
Sings it, and you know they got a four-part quartet. Well, there's only two of us up here, so but we're gonna do our part trying to get this thing right here. Let's see.
Mark Lowry, he's a funny old man. He's a trip, man. We used to go see him at the Jubilate in North Carolina. They done away with that, but got a lot of good memories with him. He's a funny guy.
Let's go.
If I can remember my part.
What's not to love?
What's not to love?
What's not to love? What's not to love? I'd like to know.
Like to know.
What's not to love?
What's not to love?
What's not to love? Him, everything's gonna be alright. What's not to love? What's not to love? I walk
Singing we had tonight. We just pray, God, that we'll go out and be better for witness of you, Lord, tonight. What we heard tonight filled our souls with good music and with your spirit. And we just pray, God, that we'll be good witnesses wherever we go in the days ahead. Bless our church. Continue to bless our singings and our dinners. And, Lord, we just, for Wednesday night, our services on Sunday, continue to bless our church. Continue to bless all the churches. Lord, we pray as the virus continues to hopefully rebate or debate or whatever it is and get away out from here and vaccination, Lord. And thank you for ministries that's opened up to nursing homes and things of this nature. Lord, we just pray to continue at your word through song and word and through preaching and all will continue to be able to get back to going out to where people can be able to hear the gospel through word and song. So, Lord, we love you. Thank you for your love for us and continue to bless our church, bless everyone here tonight, all their families, and just go with us now to our homes and give us a good rest of the week. And we'll just thank you and praise you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. God bless you. Y'all have a good week.
Yes. We're going to close out with one song.
Okay, yeah, y'all go ahead. Y'all go ahead.
Appreciate y'all.
Enjoy.
We got Keep the Night on the drums.
Yeah.
Margo on the bass, Jimmy Gill's trap on the piano.
Yeah, that, the prettiest song he ever written was that, though. Maybe Did You Know? I didn't know he did that until about a year ago. I didn't know he wrote it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that old nut wrote some nice songs.
I'll try to get it. We'll close that last, the last part of it with a shitty thing.
Okay.
We'll save that intermission just because
of that. Right.
start right on the money.
Let's see ya. Because I pray in my quiet time for y'all, and you're Keith. I mean, you're Jimmy Gilstrap.
Right. Right.
Keith is on the piano.
Keith and I.
He's
on the drums.
Drums. I'm sorry. Keith,
Jimmy,
what's his last name?
On piano.
What's his last name?
Knight.
K-A-N-I-P-E.
And Jerry and Pam, and you, so good, my brother, and bringing those sports songs. I love them.
What's my Vietnam veteran? What's in your name? My Vietnam vet.
My name is Marjo. It's spelled M-A-R-J-O-E. It's from Mary and Joseph in the Bible, is where I come from.
Okay, I
Davis.
Got you.
Davis.
Davis, I got you.
All right.
I keep y'all in my prayer.
I've always known Marjo.
Except the last one.
My mother was Davis.
Mm-hmm. You know, I ain't never heard nobody named Marjo my whole life.
Yeah,
Marjo. Who?
Marjo.
Never heard of him. You the first Marge I've ever heard of.
I guess y'all can close this out while we pack it up.
Keep going. While I was singing, somebody heard. While I was singing.